to make a quick demonstration. This is a re-video review. So whatever teacher is in this room at this time, you can pause at any point. So to make sure that students have done this process. Just as a quick reminder, you have our learning targets that we're learning, what we're working on, just to make sure that you are aware that we have everything in place. Please make sure that you're in your correct seats. And as I pull up our learning targets, please go to WeVideo, and then I'll start the demonstration. So please make sure that you all revert back to our learning target for the class. So obviously this is going to be changed for this week, and I'm going to change the date right here. So our learning target is the group news development, but also we're going to add WeVideo review. Okay, so this is a part of our videography unit. Yes, I know we're working on the news broadcast, but this is what we're working on today. Our success criteria can place raw footage in a shared folder. I can work on my news group, which you should be setting in your news group to get help as you go through this process. I can complete my workflow in the teleprompter, which you will do that when I return. I can use Adobe Spark to create my group's logo, and we'll talk about that. I can set up the Go Wireless mics, and you all have already done, I think everybody has done that, but I'm going to review that as well when I return. So here's what I want to do. I want everybody to go to create new and go to video, and we're going to choose horizontal. It'll open up and just click start editing. Now you have your footage here, and we're going to use mostly stock media. So nobody will need any other media except the stock media. So the one thing that I'm going to do is I want you to hit text. We're going to open up a motion intro. So let's choose the snippet quote. Step one, choose the snippet quote. Okay. That being said, you're going to go in here. And what I want you to do is you're going to place a quote in this and give the credit to a person of the quote that you choose. So how are we going to do that? Let's jump over to Google, and I am going to pull up a quote from Bill Walsh, one of my favorite football coaches of all time. And we are just going to see what Bill Walsh has to say. Good talent with bad attitude equals bad talent. So what we're going to do is we're going to take that, and I'm going to copy that. And I'm going to go back to WeVideo, and I'm going to paste. Okay. So then so it's just not on one line right there. I'm going to split it up. Okay. And let me go back and get rid of what I don't want. There it is. Okay, so this will take some time. Good talent with bad attitude. We'll say good talent with Control X is a good shortcut. Good talent with bad attitude equals bad talent. And we're going to give Bill Walsh the credit. Okay, so it's a great way to do that. If you want to go in here and hit manual and make the name larger, you can, which I will. Okay, and now he has got the credit. You want to come up here and you want to make it Crawford Colors. Let's do that. Don't forget 00B050 is the Crawford Green. Okay, so that is a little brighter. And then what I'm going to do here is if you want to make the scale larger, let's make it big, big, big. Save changes. Let's check it. Good talent with bad attitude equals bad talent. Okay, Bill Walsh. So now we've got our opening credits. Okay. And we're gonna wait to put who this is by. Okay. So before we add anything else, let's go back and look at our stock media. Okay. So let's see if I can find something with a good attitude. Okay. So I've got good talent with bad attitude equals bad talent. Let's drop in our first video here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it right beside my text. Okay. I'm going to drop it right beside my text and I'm going to look at the whole thing just to see what it looks like. So you got the quotes, you got the quotation, you got the credit, and then we're going to drop into positivity. And this is going to be something that's going to be really cool. So this could be like everything that is based on the quote that we just put. Okay. The next thing, you're going to hit the transitions. So teacher that's in the room, you might want to pause to make sure. Then this is also for all my classes today, except for sixth grade. We'll be doing something different for sixth grade. But everybody else is going to be doing a WeVideo review to make sure you understand all aspects of WeVideo. Real quick, just a reminder for my other classes, our learning target for third period and sixth period is video development with WeVideo and broadcasting techniques. This is going to be more of the WeVideo development. And basically, our learning target is very similar. Obviously, we're not working on the commercial today, but we can be in our groups. But this could be a short snippet also for your commercial. So this is what you got. I want to do something with the crossfade in between. So I'm going to drop that in between there. And let's look at and see what it says or see what it shows. We got a little drop, crossfade, nice and smooth, good, positivity, and that's in. Okay, so now we've got that. Let's go back into our stock media and let's see what this shows. Doubt, confidence, and so let's drop that down. And what I think I'm going to do is let's drop everything down to the video one and we'll leave the text there. Okay. That might be where we're going to put our logo. Okay. So, and I'll show you that in one moment. So let's go in back to my media. Let's go to transitions and drop the crossfade right there. And then we're going to drop the crossfade. So what I want is I want a crossfade in every in-between sequence and every clip. Like I got a clip right there. Crossfade. I got a clip right there. Crossfade. Then I got a clip right there. All right. So teacher, right now, if you would, who's covering my class, please pause it. Let's go back and review. Okay, so we're back to it. So the next thing is I'm gonna go back to my stock media. I'm still back in positivity. Let's see what this shows. Cool, positivity. So there's a lot of cool things there. So what are we gonna do in between? We're gonna hit crossfade. There it is. Go back to stock media. See what this shows. Oh, attitude, awesome. Okay, so we're gonna drop that in. Perfect. Transition. What are we going to choose? Crossfade. Okay. So we can go back and check that. Okay. Now, if you want, you want to make them larger, you can go to this plus and minus. If you want to get in there, you could come in here and hit the snippet tool or the scissors, but I'm going to hit Control Z to undo and come back to the smaller scale. Okay, let's go back to stock media, see what else we got. All right, here's some actual footage. So now she is shaking her head at the dude, at the guy, because he doesn't have good attitude, transition, and crossfade. Okay, so now let's go look at it real quick. So we have, this is 40 seconds so far. Good talent with bad attitude equals bad talent. Bill Walsh. Positivity. Boom. We got that. People coming together and then transition. Boom. You know, and then it has your little deal there. Awesome. Okay. And then the next thing, we got our attitude road that takes us to the arrow and then the girl doing her thing in art and the guy doesn't want to do it. And she's shaking her head like, what are you doing? Okay. What are you doing? Why are the guys so immature? All right, so optimism, let's go with that. Looks pretty good. Okay, so, and again, you can do what I'm doing or you can do your own thing. It's either way, but I would prefer you do your own thing if you would. So in between two clips, what are we going to do? Transitions. Now, we always have been used crossfade, so let's branch out. Okay, let's look at something crazy like curtains. Okay. She's shaking her head, and we're going to do curtains, and there you go. So curtains sometimes are a little different. So from here on out, you can choose any cross, any transition you want. I'm going to go back to stock media, and let's see what else we got. I like that growth mindset. That's pretty cool. Let's throw that in there. Transitions. Let's see what other transitions we got. Let's get crazy here. Parasol. So now we're kind of having a little fun with it. You know, there's a lot you can do with WeVideo, as you know, because we've done a lot. So this is cool. Fixed mindset, growth mindset. So there's a lot of stock here that we can use, okay? All right, so the next thing. Again, let's review our learning targets for the day. And there's our other learning targets. And then that's our fourth. Now, fourth period, we're going to start with our WeVideo. And this is new to you. So fourth period class, you might need to hit the pause a few more times because you are a little bit behind because we've been doing photo manipulation. So now let's look at this. Let's go into another program. We're going to hit a new tab. And we're going to call this Adobe Spark Post. Okay, Adobe Spark. And we're going to open that up. Now, when you open that up, you hit sign in and you continue with Google and you use your name and you go Enterprise ID. Okay, so now we're going to hit our logos up. This is what we're going to do. Now, I've got mine set and there's a lot of cool things that we've done. There's a logo for the new news broadcast. So let's go into my projects and I'll show you some logos that we've done. This is where you're going to create your own group logo. Now here's my Expos logo. This is potentially our Crawford Middle School logo that we're hopefully going to put on every door in the building. Maybe. Okay. So what I'm going to do since I've already created that, I'm going to use that. Okay. So for this, I'm going to download that. Okay, I'm going to download that as a JPEG. Okay, so that went to there. All right, now for you guys, what I'm going to do, and of course you hit download right there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my home, hit plus. I'm going to hit custom size graphic and popular square. Next. Okay, again, teacher who's covering, please make sure you pause and review as I would in moving around the room. We will review this when I return, so don't stress. If you're behind, we'll just go back. And you can also put a set of headphones in and watch this on Canvas at your own pace. So let's make sure that we put our name. Okay, there we go. Now we're going to do our logo. This is going to be a very simple logo. I'm going to hit text. I'm going to hit add your text. I'm going to put my last name, first letter of my last name, M. We'll make it really big. Okay. And then we're going to move it around. You see the dotted line where it's centered that for you. Let's come over here and change the font to something more interesting. What am I in the good mood for? All right, let's use that one because that seems like a good idea for a logo. Okay. Let's say I'm going to do McGuire Media. So if I want to do McGuire Media, I might go, let's see, what do we have? Let's see, we can move the shadow around. All right, so I'm going to go back and use the hex color 00B050, which is Crawford Green. Okay, I'm going to come in here. I'm going to change this to a grayish color. Okay, just any kind of gray. I'm going to move that down. Now you got a little shadow. Okay, let's look back at the let's look at the outline a little bit. Let's make the outline black or like a darker color. So that's really turning out good. Now, remember, when you do your logo, you need to indicate those that are in your group. So you have to figure it out. So what you might do is just use like the first letter of everybody's name in the group, but you need to make it look good. So when you do that, you might even have to do some cool things, like add some icons. Like, for example, I'm going to do, or you can even add some design assets. Let's go circle. Okay, so there's a circle right there. Let's see what that looks like. So I'm going to drop that underneath. And that really don't have nothing to do with media, but, you know, that's something cool to look at. So I'm going to make it bigger, you know, just for the sake of doing it. Now, obviously, I don't want that covering my M's or my M and my shadow. So I'm going to hit this and I'm going to send that to back. Okay. So that's a kind of a good example. So you can play with that a little bit. But I'm gonna look at a few other things too. When you click over here, you click logo. This is an old logo that I made that you can see, which I really like. You know, and if I want to add my logo, that's how it works right there. But I don't want to add a logo at this point. Okay, so I want to get rid of it. Okay, because I'm making one. All right. So let's see what kind of things we can do next. Let's drop that down a little bit, make sure I center it. Okay, so let's say we're going to keep it there. You know, we're saying it's McGuire Media or whatever the case may be. Remember, a logo needs to be rememberable, something to remember, but not overtake the piece. So I'm going to click download and start download. And there you go. So I've got two logos that I can use, and there they are. Now I'm going to go back to WeVideo and go back to my media. And I'm just going to drop them in. In this case, let me just put it into, let's see, let's put it into a new folder. And I'm just going to call it a WeVideo review. Okay, let me spell that right. Sorry. There you go. WeVideo review. Find that folder. Okay, and you're going to put both of them in there. So I'm just going to drop them in. And drop them in. Okay. Now there's a couple things you can use. In this case, I'm going to put it right here. I'm going to make it much smaller like that. And I'm going to put it on the bottom. Okay. And then I'm going to hit save. All right. Then I'm going to make it the full scale of what I've done. And there you go. Now, one thing you got to remember is you don't want to cover anything up. So I covered up a quotation. So I don't want to cover that up. And actually, I don't really like how that looks. So I'm going to drop this one in, see what that looks like. Yeah, that's a lot better. And now when you do the scale and you click on the editing tool, you know, you do your scale, just be aware that, you know, you need to make sure it's small enough. And I always like to put it on the bottom right. And why? Because when I go to YouTube, that's where they put it. And that seems like a good location. That's usually where people look. Okay. So let's look at it. Oh, there we go. And that's cool. That works. All right. And then we got the logo, the full scale of the project. This is yours. And then this, that way everybody knows who has created this piece. Okay. So yes, we're working on, you know, this process, doing the review, but you can have a bunch of clips without some tunes. You got to have some tunes. So let's go back to our audio. Now we've got some on text, which is our logo, and I'm just going to change that to logo. And that's video and that's audio. So let's go to our audio. Now you've got all these different things you can use, all these different cool things you can use. Or one other thing you can do is you can go to what's called Bend Sound. I've used it for many years, at least 3 years. And here's one, okay, more creative. Okay, a new beginning, a little idea. Now, that actually would fit the project that I'm working on. So what are we going to do? I just downloaded it. I went to my media. It's right there. I'm going to drop it in. Okay, or you can just use the stock audio that's right there. Okay, so let's wait to see what we have. And it's going to go. This is a 2 minute long one, but I'm going to go ahead and put it in. And here we go. So that to me seems like it's pretty cool. So what we're going to do next is we're going to make this. It's about 1 minute. That's about how long I want your alls to be, because I would like to put these as a total class project and put them in the library or the cafeteria or somewhere in the building where we can demonstrate your all's great skill. All right, so we're going to double click on the audio. I'm going to cut that because I don't need any more of it. I'm going to double click on this. Let me give you 1 second here. Double click on the audio options. Okay, and we're going to fade her out. And we're going to fade it out also. Let's see here. And then if I want, then I'm going to click on that. And click on that. And we are fading it out. So let's see what it sounds like. Now, one last thing. Let's drop one more transition in. The very end. Okay. All right. Now, one last thing as well. Let's go back to our media. Use our same, or actually, I'm going to use a different logo. I'm going to put it right here. And insert and push. And so what I'm going to do is... make it big, and then I'm going to do a transition. Okay, now there's one other thing we need to do. I want to put a creative by, so I'm going to hit a plus sign. I'm going to hit video and text. Okay, and then we're going to hit a text right here, and we are just going to drop above that like that. Edit. I'm going to put created by Mr. McGuire. Now, obviously, you can't see that, so I'm going to make it a color that I like. Here's your hex code. We're going to use 00B050, which is Crawford's green. Let's drop that down. Now we've got to be careful because it's going to get blended. So that being said, let's do something else. Let's make it thicker. And actually, we might make it black. That'll be better. Okay. Or I can just, I tell you what, I don't want to say too much. You already got Jeremy McGuire, so I can just say created by, and I think that might work, you know. And actually, if I do it right, I can put created by right there on the bottom part of the C, or better yet, let's put it on the top of the C because that actually reads better. Created by Jeremy McGuire. Here we go. Let's see what that looks like. There it is. It blends out. And last thing, but not least, is transition, crossfade, and we are done. Okay, so let's look at that. Now, last part is going to come into fish. You're going to make sure you not label it your name. Sorry about that. Sometimes I just, well, label your name. I'll just say Mr. McGuire, set HD, you want it high definition, okay? I'm going to put a thumbnail, and then I'm going to click on the drive, and for you guys, I'm going to click on the YouTube so the teachers can access it. I'm also going to put this on the Canvas. You all need to do this and make sure it's on your drive and hit export. I am waiting for it to export, so give me 1 second. It needs to be about 1 minute long. You can make it a little bit longer if you like. Please be creative and do your thing, as we've discussed in class. And this will be worth 20 points. while this is finishing up, let's review our learning target from last week that's connected to this week, which is video review. Okay. The main was I complete my group workflow. I can use Adobe Spark to create my groups, logo. And that's what we just did today. Okay. I can organize raw footage, which we used stock footage. So let me go back and see what we got. So you see that little blue bar as it's scrolling across, that's the time frame in which it'll get done. So we're going to sit and wait on it. I should be back tomorrow. So if you're not done, feel free to finish it the next day. But I would like for you to do everything in your power to try to finish this today. If you're absent and you're watching this at home, just use your Canvas tools. This will be an MP4 extension video file that you will upload when you complete it. While that's going, I'm going to open the Canvas. And I'm going to set the assignment. And again, this will be for first, fourth, third, and sixth. Assignment. New assignment. We're going to call this wevideo review for 9/22/21. Please click on this link to complete the wevideo review. 20 points online. File upload, restrict item to a MP4, and it is due on 9/22. So let's go back and look at it. So now it's done. You should be able to upload that MP4 to that. You would not have this right here. If we're having a problem, then we will, when I return, we will look at this link together. So when you click on that link, this is what it shows, the whole thing.
Chase really just doesn't want to come home.
So that's the deal, and I'm done, and it should be done. So we're going to stop recording. So that's the deal. That's what we have. So make sure you put it there. I'm going to save and publish, and I will see you all tomorrow. Bye now.